This is Fabulous 103 FM in Thailand.
Direct to your home, in the car, or at work.
Fabulous.
We kind of like it that way.
But Sodom and Gomorrah and legendary sin city of the modern days, or just a wonderful and friendly place to explore the beaches along the Gulf of Thailand. Well, as the saying goes here, it's up to you. But one thing is sure, for many men that have seen Pattaya once, their life have never ever been the same again. How do you really feel about it? Well, maybe you should visit Sanctuary of Truth, another one of Khun Lek's masterpieces, to really get to the bottom of your feelings about the city. Or you can just take your 70 cup Big Mac at the iconic McDonald's on Sukhumvit Road, where we are heading to continue our journey. In the immediate vicinity of the road passing through the city, you will see the largest 7-Eleven in Thailand. Don't ever miss that. But not so far from it, down the road, there is another traditional Thai landmark, Floating Market. Enjoy your time here looking at the Thai way of living, a bit different from the one on Pattaya Beach Road. Eat your boat noodles in the real boat, feed the baby goats, or just walk around and take some non-tourist photos and selfies. It's up to you. And if the Floating Market made you hot and sweaty, but you have your swimming clothes with you, further down Sukhumvit Road, you can float in the pools of aquavirs or just water slide and splash among the happy crowds of this movie-themed water park. Action never stops in Pattaya, and just across the road is Nong Nuch Garden and Resort. We are passing quickly section with exotic Thai fruits, enough with the fruits for now, and we are entering one of the most beautiful tropical gardens in the world. This place is, except from Pattaya itself, the biggest tourist attraction in the area, and this is also the largest botanical garden in the whole of Southeast Asia. The layout is focused on themes, and there are separate sections for different kinds of flowers and trees. But here is not only about the plants. Here you also find animal sculptures, rock arrangements, elephant shows, Muay Thai fights, spectacular traditional dance shows, and nonetheless, even the therapeutic massages. There are also two car gardens here, as cars usually goes together with the plants. Well, the owner of everything you see here, certain Kun Kampon Tansacha, is a big car lover, so he just placed them here on display.
Maybe something like this would be better for our crew. Definitely nothing like this.
But let's go and see the main thing here.
And the main attraction of Nong Nuch Garden,
Dinosaur Valley.
You would think that everybody's coming here for the excellently maintained green areas in the park. But judging from all the photos taken and posted on social media, most of the people come to see these statues with different rubiosauruses, triceratops, spinosauruses, T-Rexes, and another 800 sculptures of 230 different dinosaur species. Of course, kids just love them, as this place looks like some Jurassic Park frozen in the moment of time. We are still just 30 clicks away from central Pattaya, and if anyone say people don't come here for beaches, well, they just may, because there are actually some very nice beaches around. One of them we are going to visit now, because access to it is from the Sukhumvit Road, and since we are here... It's inside the Thai Navy base, but everyone get in. There is no entrance fee, and this is actually a very popular beach among Thais. It's in the very beautiful spot overlooking the northern part of the Bay of Thailand, and it's called Sai Kheo or White Sands Beach. And well, description of it is in the name. These jasmine flowers can be bought in many crossings all over the Thailand. Except for the nice scent in the car, they're also for good luck.
Just after passing city of Sattahip, we stop at another Navy base for another beach, since the best beaches around here are always inside the Navy or Army places. However...
Hello, hello.
Hi.
To the beach.
Oh, they don't allow a foreigner.
Oh, not foreigner. Huh? Just look at the beach? No, no. Cannot. Huh?
Oh.
Okay.
Ah, okay, okay, no foreigners. Okay, turn around. Huh?
Yeah.
All right.
Look, can turn back. Turn back. They don't allow foreigner. Why?
No pharynx in Thai army compound. Huh?
Nothing to do about it. We continue as we pass Utapao International Airport, and soon we arrive in the city of Rayong. We stop at PTT gas station, and Potato, as they call it here, is hands down the best gas station in Thailand. You can find everything here, and this one was especially fully loaded with Dunkin' Donuts, 7-Eleven, ATMs, Pizza Company, KFC, Amazon Cafe, and Chester's Chicken. There is always a lot of food at Potato's, and they're always the best to take a break on the road. I sound like some commercial guy, but trust me, they really don't pay me for this, nothing. Right now we're in the beginning of rain season, and as we are entering province on Chonburi, weather start to change, clouds to be very dark, and soon we are driving through the real monsoon downpour. This is why is car always better than motorbike. We're sitting in the dry, no rain on us, listening good music and enjoying our ride. But the bad weather changed back to be good very soon, and the province of Chonburi is very well known for the variety of fruits that grows here, and there are a lot of durian plantations in the area. Since we both just love durian, we are going to visit one of the plantations and maybe pick up the king of the fruits with our own hands. Thailand is the biggest producer and exporter of durian in the world, and most of the fruits goes to China.
China love durian, huh?
Yeah.
Very good, very tasty, very good, huh? You want to cut it now and go there and eat it?
Yeah, we'll put up photo to let you
try.
Wow. Oh, you know China?
How many?
Oh, it's called from here to China.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
China, Beijing.
Beijing?
Yeah.
Oh, you're Beijing, huh?
Yeah,
okay, okay. Beijing. The main city, capital of China.
We're from Beijing.
China cigarettes China. Are the best, huh? Better than Marlboro, huh?
Xiangyan. China.
Okay, let's try. Even I don't smoke.
I'm gonna smoke.
We come to see the durian, honey.
Very good, very good.
That's how your face?
You like it?
No, no.
No.
Pure cancer.
Yeah. You're not going to be able
to get out of there.
We cannot pick up durian and bring them here, but they have them picked up already. Most of the fruits are still green, since these plantations ship everything from here to China. They don't have any ripe fruits to cut and eat right now.
Musang King?
From
Malaysia? But growing up here?
Okay.
In 2 days we can eat it, huh? Okay. Bye bye China. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. See you. See you.
As we enter Trat, the last Thai province before border to Cambodia, landscapes start to change and we pass from plain to slightly more hilly areas of the country. Food and refreshments are always there from different vendors along the national route 3.
Original coffee.
Original coffee? Original from Brazil? Original coffee on my shirt, but thank God I'm well prepared and always carry dozens of white shirts in the trunk.
We are entering and passing the city of Trat, and in front of us is the only small, narrow part of Thailand.
Now we are already on the narrowest part of Thailand, and we are driving through the alley of durian plantations. On the right side we have beautiful island of Koh Kut. A little bit farther up, Koh Mak and Koh Chang, and on the left side we have Cambodia in the hills.
When you look at the map, this part of Thailand should be part of Cambodia by configuration, as it was many centuries ago during the Khmer Empire. But history is not so simple, and to make the long story short, let's just say that sometimes at the time of World War II, Thailand kicked some evil colonialist French ass, who was the occupation force in the region, and regained their territory, which at some point in the past was actually larger than just this small strip of land. But to hell with the politics and wars, let's just enjoy this moment in time and the beautiful view that is in front of us. Finally, we come to the end. Now we are at the border of Cambodia and Thailand, and this is where SUKHUMVIT road finally terminates, and on the other side it's called something else. So we finish our little bit over 500 kilometers long trip. There are trucks coming from Cambodia. Here we are, we're finishing our 2 days trip on SUKHUMVIT road. What do you think? How it has been?
Interesting.
Many things to see, many things to do along the road. Behind us we have Koh Kut, a little bit further Koh Chang.
Very nice, huh? Very? Look at sunset.
Yeah. So what do you think we go to Koh Chang?
I think very good idea.
But that's all another story that we're gonna show you in one of our future videos.